Hi everyone, today I'm going to do my first tutorial, and today's tutorial is going to be about image animations. So I just want to show you an example from what I just made. So you can do this with every image. I just called it test image, like you can see. So my image animation, what it does, it looks at every pixel, takes its value and puts it on a random place on the Tkinter canvas. And then the pixels slowly move to their respective place. So I will just show you it in action. It's not so nice as this image, because if I do it in full resolution, it would take very long because it are a lot of pixels. So now I do it on 400s of pixels, with 25 times less pixels. So like you can see, it slowly goes to their position. So their first position is random, and then it goes to their new position. Can do a lot of interesting things with it. With this, you can play around with it. Like you can see now, it's a full image. Well, I really like it. So I will explain to you how you can make these things. And yeah, I will just draw it in a little bit higher resolution. Now it's 1/10, but it's very slow. So prepare. Like you can see, every pixel has to be updated. It will probably speed this part up. So it's almost ready. And there it is, yeah, you get the idea. So let's make a basic animation. So what modules are we gonna need for this one? Well, for the repairing image, I also used time and random. You don't really need them. It's just for this particular animation, but you can do whatever you want with it. It's really up to you. There are a lot of interesting combinations. I really like animations. So if you have made a cool one, share it with me. Yeah, you can maybe place it in the comment section or so. Let's move on. So what are we gonna need, or what I used, was Tkinter for the canvas. And then we're also gonna need OpenCV. What do we need to do? First, we need to load our image. So we're gonna call it image cv2 dot image read. Oh, okay, sorry, imread. We make our window, so I just call it DK. You can call it root, you can call it window, you can call it whatever you want. It's just a new object of the DK class. We're gonna make a canvas, because how we are gonna make our pixels is by making rectangles. So that's why we're gonna need a canvas. On what the canvas? It's on our window, so DK. Then the width is, let's make it 500, and the height is also 500. And then we're gonna pack our canvas, gonna pack it up to it appears. So I will just comment this out, because now it will do nothing. So like that. Oh yeah, sorry. The reason why it's doing the animation is because I forgot to do this. So on the end, you're definitely gonna need a while loop. For your animation, you don't need this. Well, you can just comment this out, and you can just say dk.main loop. That also will work. You will see your canvas. But because I will need a while loop, I don't need to
run the main loop function.
So your what does the yeah just updating the canvas. Why do we need OpenCV? So CV2. Also, if you don't have this module installed yet, you just need to type CMD or a command prompt, because I'm from Belgium. It is opdracht prompt, but it's just command prompt. Alright, you just need to pip space install space, and then I don't know. OpenCV is a weird name for CMD, so we'll just put it on screen now. You can see it. Ready? Are you already ready? Pause this for a second. Okay, let's move on. See, we needed to get all the pixel values. There are probably also maybe ways in Tkinter. Let me know if you know better ways. But this is how I did it. Just a proof of concept. So then you need the file path. If you don't know what a file path is, it's just on Windows, it's like this. Don't forget the file extension, okay? That's very important. Don't forget it. Let's see if I have anything wrong here. Okay, so far so good. Yeah, that's why that will happen. It's normal, it's very normal. It's just because it wants to update it, but there is no window anymore if you close it. How do you solve it? Just with a try and accept block. So try that. If it gives an error, accept. Maybe not pause, but just break, because it means that the window closed, so there won't be a window again. So if you do it now, you see it works just fine. So then, because it maybe if you show the image, it's not in inverter or something or VGR for you, but technically OpenCV stores pixel values VGR, so blue, green, red, instead of RGB, red, green, blue, but we want RGB. So we need to convert this. Now it's going to be very handy to get the width and the height of the image. Well, how are we going to do it? So the height is very easy. For the height, you can just... So, yeah, probably I just need to explain this. For a second. So this image exists from it's an array. So what is it? So an array is a matrix. You write it like this. This is the array. Now there's nothing in it. You need to see this as a Y value, and then there are pixels in it. And its pixels exist from pixel data, for example, 255, 255, 255. So what is the height of the image? The height of the image is just the length of image, because the image is like a list or an array in Python. I know a list and an array is a little bit different, because you need to convert it if you want to do interesting things with it. But for now, it's just fine if we see it as a list. So, there are slots in it, so this one. That's the height in pixels of the image. So how do we write it? The height is equal to the length of the image array. So, and then the width, how we're gonna do this, because there don't exist images that have on one row that many columns, and on the other another count of columns amount. So what I just do is just the first one. So this should give us, yeah, okay. I know you can't see anything, but there is no error, so that's fine. If you want to do interesting things with it, you probably want to have a pixel class. So this pixel class, we'll just try the initialization function. What is the initialization function? It is a function that anything, so the self is needed. self is just to every object you can like call the function on it. The initialization function is just when you make the object a new object of that class, you need to specify the following things, so the things that are here. So what I will do is just the x, the y, the color, so that will be also an array with r in it, g in it, and b in it. The width, the height. If you want to do the same thing as me, you can do target x and target y, but that's not what. So I will just show you the basic, and then I will show you things that are possible with it, like exploding images and stuff. I don't know what I'm gonna program yet, but just there are a lot of possibilities with it. So if you have a good idea, let me know. Show me. Yeah, once you have the basic code, you can do anything with it. It's really fun to play around it. So, also what I forgot was on the beginning after self, canvas. Why do we need a canvas? Because canvas is a global variable and we can't get it from the class in Pixel. If you don't know much about global variables, you can search it on the internet. It's basically like in a class or something, or in a function. You can't get variables like canvas from the outside. We need to specify it, canvas. Because we are gonna need canvas probably a lot of times, or you're gonna need it, we just make a variable of its own. Then, Y position. I will just do this for a moment, and we'll come back in it. We want to know what the width and the height of the pixels can be. I will have to write a little formula like I did here. To see it. So also I'm gonna, well, you don't really need the resolution. If you don't want it, just let it out. The resolution is just how many pixels it is. And I know if you make it lower, you should really actually check all the pixels in the radius and take the mean of that or something. But what I'm gonna do now is just take the first pixel in the upper left corner. And I know that's not really efficient and beautiful. Definitely not if that pixel is white by accident. Well, yeah, the whole thing will be white. You can make much better versions of it, but I want to keep it short. So we're gonna need that. I will do that just in a second. And then we're gonna need two for loops for the y and the x. So what I'm gonna do from 0 to the height of the image, and we jump with jumps of 1 divided by the resolution. And that's round. So what is round? Round just gives the round it up. So if it's 1, it'll return 1. Why this? Because if the resolution is 1 divided by 1 is just 1 and round is still 1. So we're gonna take steps by 1. So we're gonna draw every pixel. If it's 0.1, 1 divided by 0.1 is 10. We're gonna take steps of 10. So it will be less pixel. I know this is still not right, but I'm gonna fix it in a moment. And then for x, also in range, well, what we need there, yeah. Then the formula of the width and height, a moment. Oh yeah, also we're gonna need this. So first we want to make an array of the pixels so we can loop over it and do for every pixel what you want to do so we can update them. Why is there a random tk.update in this space where you don't really need it? Well, you actually need it. Why? Because canvas.winfo width and canvas.winfo height, that's probably important to know. only like works after an update. That's weird. I know. I guess because otherwise you're gonna get a one. That's very weird. But you, what you wanna get is 500. But it needs an update, so don't forget that. Don't forget it never in your life. Maybe they're gonna fix it. I don't know. What does this formula do? So what we want really is that the width of the image is half the size of the canvas. So the center can be in the center and the left can be still the left of the the left half side of the canvas, and the right can be till the half of the right side. Yeah, that's what I meant. But then, so let's just divide it by 2. Then we also want to divide it by the width of the image. So how many pixels are in the image? If it are 1,000, it will be much smaller. If it is 1, it will be a very large pixel. So it will always be the same size times the resolution. So also the higher the resolution, the smaller the pixels, and the lower the bigger. We want to create an instance of the pixel class. So a new object pixel. Then we see the first is canvas. Then we need an x. Our x is this x. Our y is that y. The color for so will the color is image y x. Pay attention to this. It's first y then x because of the array. Like it's first the y then the x. If you think about it, it will be more logic, but yeah, sometimes it's not very logic. And then the width is just the width we calculated there, and then the height. For now, it's gonna do really nothing. You're just not going to see anything because you're not drawing anything. I want to create its body. What I mean with the body is its own pixel. So if it moves its own body, it will just move. Pixel. You can call it whatever you want, but you need to remember it how you called it. That's always very important. What's it body? So self.canvas.create. We're gonna use a rectangle for this one. So the x position, but because we want to center it, the width divided by 2, the y position. Minus the height divided by 2, and then the same thing just for the second one, but then the plus, so it will just make a rectangle at that point. I don't know if you can already see it. Yeah, we can already see tapping, but there is a little problem here, like you can see. Okay, I'm back, so I think I found it. The issue was here, so what we want to do, we want to set a variable, I'm just calling it yy, so, and then for every plus equals 1. Well, what you probably want to do is set it here minus 1, so the first time it will be just 1. And we want to set xx to 0, and here we want to do with plus equals 1, and we want to do here xx and yy. Why? Because we have the position of the pixel and we have the position of the pixel in the real image. This is the position of the pixel in the real image that we need to get the color value from. And this, the xx and yy, is a position that we're currently at. There are probably much more efficient ways of doing this. You can see you get a black square. But why do we get a black square? Well, it's very normal. You just need to center it. So how are we gonna center it? It's very easy, actually. We just do half of the canvas size, and also with that, like that. And I think no, still not it. We want to center it. And now it should be almost perfectly centered, I hope. Oh, I found it. So why is so it's second 125, yeah. I will just let it stand there. So why it is because we want to do this times width and times the height. Why do we want to do this? It's because the grids and how it works. Like you can see now, it's already beautiful grid. Now we also want to get the color. I got this. The reason why I call this hexa is because hex is a function. So it's just, I always use this one, a simple thing to get from RGB to hexadecimal. And then we can say fill is hexa, because the Tkinter needs a hexadecimal value. If you don't know what it is like binary, but instead of two possibilities, I think 16, yeah, I don't know. I'm not that kind of expert. And then because we don't want the outline, if you want it, you can let it be in there, but it probably, because the lines are pretty thick, you won't really see anything. See, I don't want the outline. How can you remove it? First, I thought it's none, but that's not how you do it. It's just setting nothing in it. And like you can see, you have already this beautiful dog. We can ramp up the resolution. It will take a little bit longer. Okay, nothing is happening. So if you have a really high resolution image, definitely, because also I'm recording at the same time. But if you just do half of the resolution, you can already see it. Shouldn't take too long. I'm recording at the same time, so I think I should let it be 0.1. Yeah. The good thing now, first, what we need to go do also before I forget it is add it to the list. So pixels are the band B. So now we also have the list with all the pixels, so we can do interesting things with them. So now what we actually want to have in our pixel is some kind of update move thing. Well, you can do a lot of things with it. I will just keep it simple. Also, if you're gonna do things with while loops and things you need to see, always import time. So you can add a time sleep take point. Also, what's really interesting to see is to update the key here, because then you can see like the image being printed out from top to bottom, left to right. So that's really interesting to see, I think. Sometimes it also looks a little bit weird. So you get the idea. But you can do really interesting things with it. For example, now I will just make a random thing. So for example, if you want to make, I don't know, an exploding image or something, you can do like for pixel, if you're ready with this, delete tk.update, for pixel in pixels, pixel.explode. For example, now it's not function, but we make an explode function. We can do something like, for example, if you make it have a velocity and an acceleration, but like if you do pixel dot explode and then init, so it knows its x and y position, for example, which we should really say like what's the difference between my x position and the one from the middle. We can make it explode from the middle out to the outside. How can we do this? Well, it's really basically acceleration x is equal to, now I have to think, self.x minus, or if I have this reverse, we'll see, minus, and then the center of the screen, so it is y acceleration, really, stop talking too much, like that, not too big, so you can just these brackets and divide it by 50 or something, I don't know. And then in move we say self dot velocity x, you get the idea. And then normally you should do like self dot x and self dot y, because we're only gonna explode once and we only need to calculate this once. What we really should do is just say self.canvas.move. So what do we want to move? We want to move our body. So this body is, so the create function always returns a number, a digit, so it's like an ID. So the first thing on the canvas is 0, the second one is 1. So I want to move it with self.velocity y. And then in while we put for p in, for every pixel in pixels. Then we want to do p.move. We probably have some errors here or there. Okay, that's a little bit weird. I mean, it kind of works. Oh, I know what it is. Its x value is like from the center of itself already. So actually, you can just do this because of how we programmed it. If you don't understand me, because we needed to do 125 plus its x, and then the rest. So that should be already much better. Now it will explode. Still going in one direction. Why is that? Plus 0 is its first x location and plus 1 is its second one. So okay. Oh no, it's reverse. That and that. Sorry, I'm really getting off topic here. Probably you already have a much better version of this. So like you can see, that worked, but maybe it's probably a better idea to make instead of acceleration, friction. Minus cost friction. So it's like first really big boom, and I don't, and I know real life doesn't work like this, but it's like boom and then, oh, wait, oh. Like that. We should probably input a sleep up here. You're still with me here. Thank you. Reading this now. No, it's not here. So before we explode the pixels, we should probably wait a bit. Like maybe 2 seconds or something. Oh. And we need to update. We now make the friction a little bit higher, so it's not really going that far. Oh. Now what we want to do is, you can add gravity to this and all. Kind of stuff. What we probably want to do is self.velocity y minus equals, we're just gonna make a constant gravity, just an arbitrary number, so just choose this one. Well, let's see what 5 does. Oh, that's right. Even I just it's plus, because in Tkinter, the higher the y value, the lower it appears on the screen. That's maybe a little bit weird, but just how it works. Yeah, but now it's just exploding so nice. So what I actually am gonna do is I am gonna import random, or from random import rendint, and so random takes 2 or even if you want 3 arguments. So we already have the first one. Then the second argument is the second one. So what I'm gonna do here is, like if you do this, you don't need to always, so like x minus points, minus 1 or something, x minus 1, and maybe we need uniform, yeah. Now it's not defined because we haven't it up here like that. So we take an arbitrary or random number between x minus 1 and plus 1. Now it should that's an interesting result. See, big mistake, but it looks really cool. Like, see, if you can whistle the things around, it's always fun. So like you can see now it's already if you then make the chain a little bit bigger, the range, I mean. So uniform takes a random number. Yeah, output random number. So you could see for collisions, you could make it fall apart and maybe make a pile on the bottom. Maybe that's what we even should do. Let's just make this very quickly. It's bigger than self.canvas.winfo width, or smaller than 0. And 0 of dot velocity x is 0. Same for y, but y is only if it's bigger than the height. Like that, maybe that works. No, definitely it doesn't work. Let's see why it doesn't work. Maybe we should. If we just do it like that, there's probably a much more handy way doing this. Just like that. And if you then use this one also up here and move, and instead of self.x we take self.plus zero. We can also make this in without an or statement. Yeah, but if you make, this one is actually 3. This one is 2, because 0 is the left side, 1 is the upper, no, the bottom, 2 is the right, and 3 is the bottom. Still doesn't work. Oh yeah, you can see them lying on the bottom. But then, if it's bigger, then that's it. Oh no, now it's 1. Right? And this one is also 1. So in the beginning I was right, right? Okay, wait. Okay, then this one is 2. Sorry for all the confusion. No, it doesn't work anymore. No, I was right. Gosh. Tkinter is confusing, alright. Sometimes. A little bit. Yeah, you can see it falling down side instead of going more. So you can do interesting collisions. You can make something like my other one, repairing image. It starts at a random position and then it all goes. Yeah, but maybe we should do less high resolution, that it starts a random location at the screen, and okay, that's slow. Why is it doing that? Okay, so it starts at a random location at the screen and repairs itself, or you can apply physics to it like I did, but then better. You can do a lot of things with it. If you make, if you have an ID and you worked it out and it works, okay. Oh yes, true. Actually, if you have an ID and it worked out, you can place it on GitHub and place a link in the video comments. In the comment section down below. If you like this tutorial, because you can do a lot of things with it, you can also do it with text. You can, like, I just want to set you, give you a little bit of ideas, right? But like you can see, we just make 2 animations. Well, this one we didn't make. We'll probably try to upload also the source code again on GitHub. So if you don't want to type, you can get it from there. So thanks for watching, guys. If you enjoyed it, please like, comment, subscribe. maybe share it with your friends. That would really help me out because this is still a small channel. So thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Bye.